tonight on Parker and Parker. He was at Redskins Park bright and early today, but...
You weren't there very long.
No, I wasn't there very long. Obviously, we can go into the building, but they won't allow us to work out right now.
Fan favorite Lorenzo Alexander joins us live to talk lockout. Plus, as the Red Hot Caps wait to see who awaits them in the next round, we talk playoffs with a very familiar voice. And a proposal from left field does quite a number for one faithful fan.
Are you kind of rethinking this whole idea now?
Yeah.
This Parker and Parker is a real drag, and it starts now.
For me to get a workout in here. I don't get interrupted. You know, people don't come up to me asking me about the lockout. So it's easy to stay focused.
So Lorenzo Alexander goes out to Redskins Park to finally get a workout there because it's easier to stay focused and not have people asking him about the lockout. So what happens? A bunch of media people from Channel 7 show up and ask him about the lockout.
I love that he showed up in a Prius.
This man is my hero. We're going to ask him about the Prius. Hey, everybody. We are Parker and Parker. I'm Alex.
I'm Julie.
So sure enough, the lockout ends, Julie, yesterday, or a judge says it's over for now. And then a bunch of players say, sweet, let's go to work. Sort of like you in the morning. Great, let's go to work. Lorenzo Alexander, a hard worker, shows up at Redskins Park, and then not so much. He can get in, but he can't work out. Lorenzo Alexander joins us on the line. Hey, Lorenzo, what's up, man?
Hey, what's going on with you guys?
We're good.
So you show up to work today, and Bruce Allen politely says, you're not going to work out.
Yeah, pretty much. He met me in the lobby. We went to his office and had a quick discussion and just told me pretty much the NFL is still looking for clarification on the ruling that happened yesterday. And until they receive that clarification that no one would be allowed to work out pretty much. So after that, grabbed some mail and got out of there and went over to Eddie Mason's spot and got to work.
Were you surprised, or did you somehow have an inkling that this might be the case?
Yeah, I had kind of heard through the grapevines that I may not be able to be allowed to work out, but I wanted to still go up there and, you know, show my face, let them know that I was ready to go back to work and get it in if they were going to give me the opportunity to do it.
Lorenzo, it sounds like there were different rules applied depending on which team you were with. Some of the Giants were able to go and work out, talk to the coach. We're just seeing video from Pittsburgh and Miami. Any thoughts on why it's one rule in one place and one rule in other places?
No, that's all on the ownership side as far as, you know, keeping ranks and all that. So I don't know why there's, you know, disparity between one team versus another. I just hope that, you know, our team opens it up so that we can go back and just get back to work. And because we have a lot of work to do, you know, ranked last in defense last year, and we just need to get back together so we can make a great push this year.
Lorenzo, do you have a sense of when you'll get to work out? Do you have any idea? I know the NFL is saying they need a few days to figure out the legalese. What do you think?
Nobody's really given us a timetable. I'm pretty sure, you know, within these next couple of days, I'll find out for sure, especially, you know, with the appealing process, you know, taking place, whether or not there'll be a stay or not. But, they only can do this for so long. At some point, they got to let us back in because the judge did, you know, overruling, you know, and ruling our favor as far as lifting the lockout.
So, Lorenzo, we had a bunch of various stations had various photographers staked out at Redskins Park today. And they're shooting video of the big SUVs coming in.
Right.
All the rims, everything's shining. We got bling bling everywhere.
Right.
This little white Prius comes up, and people are like, that's nobody.
Right.
That can't be a pro athlete. And then as you drive by, they go, that's him. That's Lorenzo. Dude, first of all, props to you. I guarantee you there cannot be more than a handful, if any, other pro athletes that can afford bigger and better and more gas-guzzling vehicles.
Right.
And you've got a Prius. What's up?
You know what? You know, with this lockout, with gas about to hit up to 5 gallons, who knows what it may be. You know, that 50 miles to the gallon really, you know, caught my eye. So that's why I have a Prius. I love it. Great gas mileage, you know, saving my pockets. You know, I do have a big truck, but that takes $100-something. The Prius takes $40 to fill up, and I get 500-something miles on it. So it's a no-brainer for me.
Lorenzo Alexander, do you actually pay attention to the prices at the pump?
Yes.
You
I
do?
Mean, I'm just like anybody else now. You know, I have some money, but that money can go fast, quickly. It's a lot of examples out there, but, you know, I came up from nothing, so I understand my roots, and just because I have it now doesn't mean I'm always going to have it, so I'm conservative as long as possible.
What do your teammates say? Because, listen, I've been out there. I see the big Escalades
well,
and all the
Phillip
stuff.
Philip Daniels,
nobody's
remember that?
Really seen it yet. Yeah. I just got it maybe 3 or 4 weeks ago. You know, Kedrick and those guys seen it, but they got Kedrick. Me and Kedrick actually rode to the Cavs game in it, and he actually loves it as well. They thinking about getting one themselves. So it's definitely roomy. You know, I could be a spokesman for the car. You know, it has great, you know, if I want to drive it like a real car, I just push power mode, and then I'm driving regularly. It doesn't feel like a four-cylinder. So I love it. It has everything that I need.
Beep, beep. Lorenzo, the Redskins are making a lot of news in the offseason. We're talking about the lockout. But then today, your teammate, Albert Hainsworth, was indicted by a grand jury on this incident. Did you even know about this regarding the waitress at the W Hotel in downtown D.C.?
Well, I knew of the incident, but I didn't know as far as his court case. You know, I got a lot of my own issues going on to try to keep up with Albert. So I just hopefully everything works out for him, you know, that everything comes to light and that he's innocent.
Have you talked to Albert at all since the season ended, Lorenzo?
No, I mean, I don't correspond with Albert frequently. I see him at work and stuff like that, and out I'll say what's up, but we're not on a, you know, week-to-week basis as far as calling each other.
And are you paying much attention to the lawsuit involving Dan Snyder against the Washington City paper? Do you get caught up in that?
No. I mean, you hear about it. I listen to talk radio, so, I mean, I hear about it all day, but I'm not, like, following it closely or anything. You know, that's just an incident, you know, where somebody, where he feels somebody has offended him and has wronged him, and in this country we can sue, you know, when you feel that way. So, you know, that's part of his right. He's exercising it, so more power to him, and the legal system will take care of it, and then you'll figure out, you know, who's right and who's wrong, and then they'll settle it there.
Lorenzo, thanks so much, man. Best of luck getting out there and actually working out
it.
And enjoy that Prius.
I will.
Go plug in your car. Thanks, Lorenzo.
All right, later.
Take care.
Just ahead, we are drumming up some postseason support. From the radio voice of the Washington Capitals, Steve Kolbe joins us to preview the next step in the Caps' chase for the Cup.
3 days is a long time. 4 days, you start, you know, going, okay, what's going on? And by 5 and 6 days, your wives don't like you.
The best soundbite in Washington sports and one of the best anywhere, Bruce Boudreau. Every day, that was today. Yesterday, he had a couple doozies. He's great.
He's very colorful. Now to a man whose voice you know very, very well. If you are a Washington Capitals fan, Steve Kolbe is the voice of the Caps on the radio. He joins us now by phone. How are those pipes feeling, Steve?
Well, we're getting ready to go. Just like the Capitals, we're trying to take advantage of the little bit of a gap between the series here, and it looks like the Capitals won't have to worry about playing the Buffalo Sabres. The Flyers have the Sabres down 3-0 right now in their game, and looks like they're well on their way to winning Game 7. So that would take the Sabres out of the mix. But still, even if that happens, the Capitals won't know who their next opponent will be. It would then be either Montreal if they hang on to win against Boston tonight, the Tampa Bay Lightning, or the Pittsburgh Penguins. So Bruce Boudreau and his coaching staff really have their work cut out for them, trying to prepare for one of 3 or 4 different teams the Capitals could meet.
But, Steve, so if Philly wins, but Montreal wins as well, it's Montreal. They would know tonight at 10:30 or whatever.
Well, they would know in Game 7. If Montreal wins tonight against Boston, that would force a Game 7 back in Boston between the Habs and Bruins, which means that if Montreal were to win that Game 7 as well, if they hang on to win and they're up 2-1 right now against Boston, if Montreal were to win, that sets up a rematch of last year's first-round playoff series between the Capitals and Montreal. I think there are quite a number of different interesting scenarios here. If Tampa Bay gets through, the Capitals will face a division rival. If it's Pittsburgh, everyone knows about the rivalry between those two teams, although it may lose something in terms of the luster without Sidney Crosby.
Who do you prefer? Who would you like to see the Caps play, Steve?
Well, you know, right now, I don't think it really matters who the Capitals meet. Michael Neuwirth is playing so solid. The Capitals defensively have been rock steady inside their own blue line. They were able to win the close games, win without scoring the first goal against the Rangers. Their penalty kill was almost unbeatable. They gave up just one power play goal against New York while scoring three themselves. I think when you take a look at the what matchup could be potentially dangerous, every one of them have something that could go against the Capitals. Ryan Miller for the Buffalo Sabres, always a wild card, but now it looks like Buffalo's out. Montreal's got some speed. Carey Price has been up and down so far in the playoffs. Pittsburgh, they've been able to get it done even without Sidney Crosby and Evgeny Malkin in their lineup for the better part of 3 months. And Tampa Bay, they've got a host of forwards, LeCavalier, St. Louis, Malone, and Stamkos up front that can really do some damage. So it doesn't get easier as this playoff season goes along.
Steve, I was out at Kettler yesterday, and there seems to be this sort of resolve with this team. I don't know how to describe it other than this sort of maturity and this, sure, they're glad they beat the Rangers, but this, what would you call it? They're not satisfied by any means, and there's this calm amongst them.
I would call it a long memory. The Capitals know that they're not going to just get by the Rangers and have the second round handed to them by whoever they happen to face, because they're going to take a look over to Vancouver and see what's happening to the now President's Trophy winning Canucks, who are on the ropes in a game number 7 later tonight against Chicago. And the Capitals know just how hard it's going to be. Mike Green and the Capitals had a slogan: stay angry, believe in yourselves. The team printed t-shirts back during training camp. Mike Green is still wearing that t-shirt today, both in games and also in practice.
The Caps have called up Braden Holtby from Hershey. Steve, what does that tell you?
Well, it just tells me the Capitals, with Hershey out of the American Hockey League playoffs, are going to bring in an extra netminder. That takes some of the burden off of Michael Neuwirth and Semyon Varlamov, which means they don't have to take all of the extra drills. It also allows Braden Holtby, and the Capitals can carry as many players as they want right now with no salary cap. The Capitals know that Braden Holtby could be one of their keys to the future. He gets to feel the intensity of the National Hockey League playoffs. I wouldn't read much into it aside from that. Michael Neuwirth is the guy right now. Michael Neuwirth, with the exception of an injury or a bad game, I'd expect him now to run the table in terms of however long the Capitals are alive.
Neuwirth has been, he too, when you talk to him, he just has this, like, confidence. It's not cocky, but it's very impressive. 23 years old, his first Stanley Cup playoff action. What do you make of this guy? How's he done it?
I think that his confidence has grown throughout the year, and he came in that way in training camp knowing that he was a proven winner at the American Hockey League level. And I look back to his overtime games, and I just happened to double-check this today. In overtime of the last 3 playoff seasons, 2 at the AHL level, now 1 here in the National Hockey League, he is 10-2. And that's pretty impressive for a guy who, when that all started, was 21 years of age and really has been able to keep his composure. I don't think it has anything to do with Michael Neuwirth being overconfident. I think he's well within his means and confident in his ability. He's made the saves he's had to. The Capitals have given him great defense in front, and Michael Neuwirth's play at Verizon Center has been outstanding. I just wrapped up the Capitals chart for whoever they may play in the opening round. Michael Neuwirth now 15-4-3 at Verizon Center during the regular season. He was 3-0 against the Rangers. He turned away 72 of the 74 Rangers shots in the 3 home games in that first round series.
Wow, Steve Kolbe, you sound like a hockey encyclopedia, but you actually do have a private life, and you do something that I don't think most people would expect from the voice of the Caps. You're a drummer?
Is that sing opera? No, I'm kidding. No, it is. I've been playing the drums since I was a very young age. I actually studied at the Peabody Conservatory of Music for about 10 years. So that's just one of my passions, along with getting out on a bass boat in the summers and hitting the Potomac River. So you'll see me motoring up and down the Potomac at the end of June when the Capitals have done this playoff round. So one of these days, guys, I tell you what we'll do. In the off season, for a great charity, I'll get the sticks out. I don't have much time to get out the twigs recently, but I'll get the sticks out. We'll have an old-fashioned drum off for a good charity. What do you say?
There you go. I, too, play drums. I didn't study anything for 10 years. He studied the Peabody for 10 years.
So
I just put on the Police.
With your producer.
I put on the 3rd Police album, just did that for about 20 minutes, and I was good to go. Steve Kolbe, you're the man. I like the confidence. He's ready for this thing to go to mid-June.
Aren't we all?
Thank you, man. Take care, and best of luck the next series.
Anytime. We'll see you at the rink.
I like how I called them twigs.
Twigs. He's very hip.
I'm with the band. Up next, so what's your sign? How about a stop sign for this lady? She's sending out all the wrong messages. We're dialing information when Parker and Parker continues.
It's a slow dance here on Parker and Parker. Just couples only, please, for the next. This is the C block. This is the slow dance block of Parker and Parker. Julie, that's Manny Pacquiao.
He wasn't content being a world champion boxer.
Is he also a politician?
He's a Filipino congressman, and he's an actor. Who knew?
He is releasing this single. This is a remake of what's my man's name?
Dan Hill.
This was big back. You were just getting into college when this was big. Jewel, right back in the 70s?
Not the 70s.
I like the tune.
Yeah, I do.
I may buy it in my iPod. That'll somehow be between Miley Cyrus.
You're not playing it Sunday.
It'll be
on the radio.
Manny Pacquiao on the playlist, and then Miley Cyrus, and then Taylor Swift. Speaking of one-hit wonders in music, who could forget about this? Okay, Joel, you remember this. You were just getting into grad school when this came out.
That's right.
Tommy Two Tone, there's a reason we're doing this on a sports show.
Look at her.
I would argue, yeah, look at her.
Foxy.
If you're into that sort of thing. She appears to have just gotten off the set of Gone with the Wind. I would argue this is the most famous phone number in the history of the world.
Until now.
Other than like 555-1212, kind of whatever. So this is the phone number until now. Julie, you know what happened at a baseball game in Milwaukee like a day or two ago.
Well, this is what happens when you hold up a sign and it winds up on TV. And you put your phone number out there and you ask the player to marry you.
So this Brewers fan says, Ryan Braun, marry me. And we have blurred out the number. Who are these people, by the way, that wave? Can these people go
the
to prison?
Drunk guys from Section 400.
Can this woman go to prison for this? So this woman, the blonde there, her name is Robin. She didn't think by putting her phone number on there that was like a bad idea.
It turned out to be.
600 text messages, 400 phone calls, just in the time it took this reporter from the Brewers TV network to find her. By now, you can only imagine she's had tens of thousands of phone calls.
Plus
three of which were from me, because I'm trying desperately to get her on Parker and Parker. Robin, come on.
I called her. It went to voicemail.
I left a message, but it doesn't go right to voicemail. It's not like it's disconnected. It rings, and I'm like, she's going to pick up.
But within like a minute and a half or whatever it took him to walk from the...
And find her.
To her, 600 calls or texts.
The Ryan Braun guy got wind of this. Ryan Braun, rock star for the Brewers. And then here's the deal, what Ryan Braun at least tried to do.
Hey, you reach Robin. I can't get to the phone right now, so if you could leave your name, number, and a brief message, I'll get back to you as soon as I can. Thanks. Bye.
Are you on speakerphone?
Sorry. That voice mailbox is full.
Later. Hey, not meant to be.
We had the Brett Favre shot for a little
what?
In the beginning of that.
The what shot?
Never mind.
The Brett Favre shot? You're going to bring up the Brett Favre shot in the middle of, I want to hold you till I... Die.
We're coming back to put the wraps on this numerically numb edition of Parker and Parker as we bring you the thrill of victory and the agony of defeat. Guys, don't try this at home. Alex already has. Or at least wait until the significant other has left the house.
Watch out!
Thank you, Manny Pacquiao. Make sure you join us on the radio on Sundays, 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. If you like this song, we'll play it. We're on 106.7 The Fan. We take your calls, your tweets, your texts. We are on Twitter at Parker and Parker, and we're on Facebook there as well.
We might be able to get the Dan Hill guy to call in. We had Tony Tenniel last week. If we can have Tony Tenniel on, we sure as heck ought to be able to get Dan Hill.
Let's get to the drag race.
Okay, drag race. Dateline, Key West, Florida.
Shocker.
These are men dressed as women, if you couldn't tell, Julie Parker.
That's like the giant grocery store.
Yeah, exactly. They're in the bread aisle. Watch out. These are people, Jewel, that have too much time on their hands. Fill the folks in case they want to come visit.
Well, if you're headed to Key West, this whole celebration will run through May 1st. with events including a sea battle featuring historic tall ships and an open-air bed race billed as the most fun you can have in bed with your clothes on.
Okay, moving on. This story really is something else. Two buddies in New York. Hey, let's go to L.A. How should we get there? Why don't we just take a cab? So they get some dude. Hey, dude, can you take us to L.A.? The guy says, sure. After 6 days, they got there today.
It took a while. They had to convince someone to drive them that far. What did it cost?
It was supposed to cost $13,000. That was the sticker price, as it were. It cost $5,000. Here's the problem. They don't have any more money. Nobody knows how they're getting back.
If they took Lorenzo's Prius, it would be about $2,500.
They could drive to Sweden. Here we go. Props. Parker and Parker props go out to 85-year-old Elena Griffin, Julie Parker of Berkeley, California. She is 85. She has worked 60 straight years without a sick day. Weren't you sick Friday, Jill?
Julie's sick like weekly.
Julie's done. She missed last Friday. Other than that, how about this woman? She started in 46 when Harry Truman was president. The minimum wage then was 40 cents an hour. That's actually still what it is on this show. It's actually a little high.
That's it for this edition.
Congratulations, Elena.
Thanks for joining us, and thanks to Joe Corey at Facciluna for the terrific dinner, as always. Check him out next time you're in Arlington for all of our guests and the entire crew. I'm Julie. He's Alex. Catch us on The Fan on Sunday, 10 a.m. Have a great night.